Hello students, myself Ganvi, assistant professor SGM College Ujire. In previous class I have given the introduction to the substituted acids. There way I have given the example for what are substituted acids and halogen substituted acids and hydroxy group substituted acid, and also shown preparation for hydroxy substituted acids. In this video once again I am going to give some of the other examples and their preparation and their chemical reactions. We'll see one by one, that is malic acids, which is occurs in the apple, and hence its name is called as malic acid, which is a common name where malus refers to the apple, that is a Greek word. Okay, so usually these acids are named by common name. Okay, so IUPAC name is alpha hydroxy succinic acids. Okay, where in malic acid that is only one hydroxy group, you can say this is the example of hydroxy group substituted acid, but it is a di acid, so there are two carboxylic group. Okay, and it is used as a used to make the medicines, and people take malic acid by mouth for the tiredness and the fibromyalgia. And in foods, malic acid is used as a flavoring agent and to give the food tart taste. Okay. And it in manufacturing, malic acid is used to adjust the acidity of cosmetics, and usually these acids are somewhat acidic. Okay, so adjust the acidity, it is used in the cosmetics. We'll see the preparation of this malic acid. First one, that is from the malic acid. When malic acid is treated with dilute sulfuric acid at higher temperature, so dilute sulfuric acid refers to in presence of water, you can see. So at higher temperature what happens is addition of this hydroxy group takes place to this double bond, since malic acid, and go through the spellings here, it is malic, where that is L-E-I-C, malic acid is M-A-L-I-C, that is only a difference. So from malic acid, which is having double bond, where addition of water molecule takes place, so to the one carbon there is an addition of hydroxy group, to the other carbon there is addition of hydrogen takes place. As a result we are going to get the malic acid. And the next method is from succinic acids. So this is the structure of succinic acid, which is one of the dicarboxylic acid. When you treat this succinic acid with bromine, addition takes place, as a result which adds to the one of the carbon. Okay, we get the bromosuccinic acid, monobromosuccinic acid. When you treat this with silver oxide or with silver hydroxide, where this bromo group is replaced by hydroxy group, as a result we are going to get the malic acid. That is one of the preparations. Let us see the chemical reactions of this malic acid. First one is reduction. When you do the reduction of this malic acid in presence of hydrogen iodide, so we can use any other reducing agent. Here I am going to tell about only hydrogen iodide. So when you reduce, usually this hydroxy group removal takes place in the first, at the beginning removal of hydroxy group takes place, as a result we are going to get the succinic acid. And the second method, that is action of heat. So when you heat at higher temperature, when you heat this malic acid at higher temperature, we are going to get the mixture of two products, that is malic acid and fumaric acid. So what is the difference between malic and fumaric acid is, you can see in COOH group, which is present on the same side in malic acid, in fumaric acid, which is present in opposite side. The structure is same, so whatever the carbon, hydroxy groups, oxygen groups are same, only it is a carboxylic group which is in opposite side, we can say like cis trans. Okay, that is about the chemical reaction. So next example I am going to take is citric acid, which is also one of the substituted acid. Okay, we'll see the structure. This is the structure of citric acid, where as I said, this is example for hydroxy substituted acid. This is the hydroxy group in carboxylic acid, in one of the hydrogen in alkyl group, which is replaced by hydroxy group. And this is example for tricarboxylic acids also. Okay, it is also can be named as 2-hydroxy-1,2,3. It is 2-hydroxy propane tricarboxylic acids. So since it is acidic, already as I said, citric acid usually which is present in all kinds of citrus fruits, maybe like a lemon, orange, you can see in that citric acid is present. And since it is already the taste is sour taste, okay, since it is acidic, sour tasting nature, citric acid is predominantly used in flavoring as well as preservating agent, especially in the soft drinks as well as candies, okay. And it is also used in the stabilize or preserve the medicines and disinfect against virus or bacteria. And in addition to that, it is also used in cleaning products and also used for personal care, agriculture, food and pharmaceutical and electroplating industries, so which is having highest applications, okay. We'll see the synthesis of this citric acid. So first I'm going to explain only one method, that is from glycerol. Okay, when you treat this glycerol is example for trihydroxy acid. You can see there are three hydroxy group. Okay, when you treat this with two molecules of hydrogen chloride, where the Cl is replaces only two primary hydroxy group, as a result we are going to get this product. When you do the oxidation, of this compound, okay, so oxidation you can do with any reagent like HNO3R, potassium permanganate, etc., where that hydroxy group is converted into carbonyl groups, okay, carbonyl group. In the next step, when you add HCN, that is hydrogen cyanide, addition reaction takes place. The cyano group add to the carbonyl carbon, when bond shifts, we will get the hydroxy group as well as cyano group. Okay, in the next step, once again when you treat with potassium cyanide, this potassium cyanide, where cyano group which replaces the two chloro group, as a result we get three cyano groups. And in previous slide also I have shown that when you do the hydrolysis of this cyano group, we are going to get the carboxylic group. Okay, that is the familiar step, hope you know, right? So the in this way we are going to get the citric acid. That is about the preparation of citric acid. Okay, next we will see the chemical reactions of citric acid. First one, that is acetylation. You can see this. This is the citric acid structure when you treat with acetyl chloride. Okay, so there will be a replacement of this hydrogen by the acetyl group. As a result, we are going to get the monoacetyl citric acid. So don't confuse with the structures, since it is very big. So only see where the reaction takes place, only that portion you observe, so that becomes very easy to study also. And the second reaction, that is reduction with hydrogen iodide. When you treat the citric acid with hydrogen iodide, when you reflex this at higher temperature, so this hydroxy group is going to remove. As a result, we are going to get the tricarboxylic acid. So only changes is removal of hydroxy group. Here you can see that is the tricarboxylic acid. And the third reaction, that is action of heat. Okay, when you heat the citric acid at higher temperature, once again when you heat, obviously we know that removal of water molecule or else carbon dioxide takes place. So here removal of water molecule, since there is a hydroxy group, removal of water molecule takes place. So that is hydroxy group from here and the hydrogen here. As a result, we will get the double bond at this region. So whatever the compound we get, that is called as aconitric acid. It is a common name. Okay, so reaction once again continues. It does not stop there, where this aconitric acid which undergo decarboxylation, when you heat further, which undergo decarboxylation, which gives the two type of products. Either decarboxylation takes place to this carboxylic group, either which can remove here, either carboxylic group can remove here. If it is removed here, we are going to get the citraconic acid. You can see the structure. If this carboxylic group is removed, we are going to get the itaconic acid. So we are going to get the mixture of product. Once again, reaction does not stop at that stage, which undergo dehydration. So removal of water molecule takes place once again. So as a result, we are going to get the corresponding anhydrides. You can say by the removal of water molecule OH group from one carboxylic group and hydrogen from other carboxylic group. By the removal of this water molecule, once again formation of new bond takes place at this region. We are going to get the citraconic anhydride. Similarly, with itaconic acid, we are going to get the itaconic anhydride. So to say that it may look like big structures, but just look at the where the reaction takes place, what product we are going to get. Only look, concentrate on the bonds, so that will become easy. Okay, hope you understand. Thank you.